The Umbrella Academy Series 2 sees our batch of super-powered siblings thrown back in time to the 1960s, scattered across different years leading up to the assassination of President John F. Kennedy. The assassination is woven into the series' various plot threads because, in the absence of Five, who arrives later than the others, the siblings kinda cause another apocalypse, and the killing or not killing of Kennedy is crucial to preventing it. Diego is planning to kill Kennedy's assassin, Lee Harvey Oswald.
Disturbed man with multiple knives arrested outside 1026 North Beckley. That's Lee Harvey Oswald's house.
Luther is working as a bodyman for Jack Ruby, the man who would later kill Oswald. And Five is given footage from the day of Kennedy's assassination showing a figure holding an umbrella standing alongside Kennedy's route. A figure who turns out to be his father, Sir Reginald Hargreaves. This last subplot fits so well with the umbrella-heavy iconography of the show that you might not realize that the Umbrella Man is as real as Oswald and Ruby. He really was on the spot when Kennedy was killed, and he really did not only hold an umbrella, but open it and wave it around as the president approached. Perhaps understandably, he's been a key part of the conspiracy theories surrounding Kennedy's death for decades. So, assuming he wasn't actually Sir Reginald Hargreaves, who was he? The Umbrella Man was a bystander in the crowds gathered to watch President Kennedy as he travelled through Dallas on November the 22nd, 1963. The man was standing in Dealey Plaza, underneath the Stemmons Freeway sign, very close to the point where the first shot was fired at the president. As photographs and film footage of the assassination were published, the Umbrella Man began to attract attention. November the 22nd was a sunny day. The crowds weren't wearing raincoats or carrying umbrellas, so why did the Umbrella Man have one? And why did he open it and hold it above his head as the president approached? Conspiracy theorists had some suggestions. Researchers Josiah Thompson and Richard Sprague were among those who first noticed the umbrella and speculated that it had been used to signal hidden gunmen to fire on the president. A version of this idea is seen in Oliver Stone's 1991 film JFK and in the X-Files retelling of the assassination. That's your cigarette-smoking man there, taking the shots. Some theories went further and suggested that the umbrella itself was a CIA-designed weapon capable of firing shots at the president or paralyzing him with poisoned darts. Conspiracist Robert Cutler even came up with a diagram of how the weapon supposedly worked. Strange ideas. But there is a mystery in why a man would be holding an umbrella on a clear sunny day. And there's something bizarre in how he opened the umbrella as the president approached and waved it around. In the frenzied scramble for truth in the aftermath of the assassination, it's not surprising the Umbrella Man accumulated such significance. In 1978, after an appeal by a government committee looking into the assassination, Louis Stephen Witt came forward and identified himself as the Umbrella Man. He'd gone to Dealey Plaza to heckle President Kennedy, he said, and had brought the umbrella because, well, this is the weird bit. The umbrella wasn't really a dig at Kennedy, it was a dig at his father, Joseph, who had been the US ambassador to Great Britain before World War II and had supported Neville Chamberlain's policy of appeasement. By waving a black umbrella, which had been one of Chamberlain's trademarks, Witt was going for a deep-cut political burn. Essentially, your dad was friends with the man who appeased Hitler and had an umbrella. Super niche. Though it makes more sense when you know JFK wrote a thesis at Harvard called Why England Slept, about appeasement. So, perhaps weirdest of all, he probably got it. In explaining his actions and commenting on the controversy they had caused, Witt said, "I think if the Guinness Book of World Records had a category for people who were at the wrong place at the wrong time, doing the wrong thing, I would be number one in that position, without even a close runner-up." And we thought the plot of the Umbrella Academy was confusing. The Umbrella Academy Series 2 is available on Netflix right now. Give this video a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to the channel for more videos on all your favorite Netflix shows.